Boemers Cuppers hier.
Ja, Chuck.
Ja. Captain put you up. Wait. Of course, say four batteries. So this is it first. Yes. Salute all subscribers and viewers.
What did you say, sir?
Salute all subscribers and viewers. Thanks for your support for visiting our channel, for all your comments.
Hey, you're not in overall, say. What's this, say?
What?
You're not
well, it's Sunday, so for once, say, I can be dressed a little better, eh? For your support for visiting our channel. For all the comments, for the subscriptions, and of course for sharing and spreading the passion from the RC planes from this channel to the rest of the world, eh?
Yes.
Yeah.
And now back to you.
And I'm talking to who right now?
We're talking to yourself, eh?
The famous question on this channel today, I'll be quick, I won't talk too much. What do we have? Look at this and be impressed, eh?
Hey, look at this. Look at this small size, eh? It's even...
Yeah, but even your plane is small, eh?
It's almost smaller than my engine, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, but I mean, this is unbelievable, eh? Beautiful and sexy. I will grab it in my hands because, I mean, my friends, with this pen and lines, I have put it even a little see-through lacquer on. I mean, look how sexy this plane looks. The Isshin F-16 Falcon, the beautiful and sexy mini jet, eh?
Yes.
That will run on 4-cell and it comes, of course, ready to fly in the box. Eh?
And you forgot to say on the unboxing that you get two batteries.
Yeah,
one battery
course.
Is actually inside the transmitter.
The basic version comes with two batteries. One is in the plane, the second one was in transmitter. But you can later also choose for with three batteries or four. But I didn't because I already have a plane. That we have filmed the first flight.
Yes.
The Mini Mustang. I mean, my friends, this is amazing flyer. It's unbelievable for such a small plane. Maybe many viewers will say, but that is too small, that is nothing. But hey, you have to try. If you have a good eyes and you see the planes good in the air, do try this because you will really have the fun and the feeling like you're flying a big plane.
What?
It's really amazing.
This plane actually weighs 60 grams?
Yeah, it's really small.
No, that one.
Yeah, of course it does, say. And I will tell you right now, because all that you need, you get in the box, like I have said. I have now four batteries. They all charge with the same charger and they're all 1-cell 400 milliamp batteries.
Yes.
And I will show you something else. I hope that it will work today. Of course, you get a few spare parts. I won't tell nothing about the assembly because you don't need to assemble here nothing. And I won't even put the wheels on because it will be silly and useless to have the wheels on this plane because they're just too small, eh?
Yes.
Yes. And I will tell you one thing. I will show you, of course, today after this filming, I will have fun with this because I have checked already, and with a single small battery like this, with this plane, I can fly at least for 10 minutes. Now, can you imagine?
Well, it says actually 15 on the box.
Yeah. Well, I was flying 10 and I have just landed because it became silly. So, today we will test the Falcon, the second one in this series of small planes. But the point is that today I will try to fly. This radio, which in fact I have binded in my workshop with the radio from this one. Now I don't have, you can see that the original radio from the Falcon is still here.
Yes.
I didn't buy the second set of the batteries. I didn't even want to take it out from this plane because I was thinking and I was reading that in fact if you get the spare parts for these planes, the spare radio is the same for all.
Mm-hmm.
So I have binded my plane at home with the Mustang radio. So if I go and if this will work, I can take on the runway just one radio and every time I plug the new plane in, it binds and the radio recognizes the plane. And this will be amazing. So that means that you don't have to have the radio for every single plane. Now, of course, I will put it like this. I have the radio here and you will see that in fact, I will fly this with the Mustang radio today.
Yes, which is the same as we said.
And look at this. Do you see? The beauty here. Of course, I will put it like this because later I will have fun with these planes. And don't throw away these boxes because these boxes you will use later to store your planes. Now, let's get to the business. I will show you the compartment for the battery. I have also marked myself the battery 1, 2, 3, 4, so I know which one I choose.
Yes.
Because they're so small that I can't even check them which one is sucked. And now I will show you the compartment for the battery. Look at this. I mean, it's amazing. Small, but you can use this
tweezers.
Because they do recommend that you don't pull too much on the wires, because these wires are small, the connectors solder inside, the connector areas are not big, so don't push too much. But one thing that I have done, you can see here, that I have cut it on this side, do you see? I have cut it out a little foam, so I can stick the cable back in, because it was really hard to close this door. And I have cut it a little foam here in the front, here. So now the battery fits inside perfect. And don't be worried. I will put this here. I will prepare the radio. First you plug in the plane and don't be scared. You have the time to put the battery in, close it, put it back on the flat surface, and then when you will plug the radio
surface,
the flat level surface, it will bind with the plane. You will see this, eh?
Yes.
You don't have to rush or I don't know what, eh? Look at this. And now the plane will wait until it will get the sign from the radio. Uh-huh. And I will put the battery in, and now I have this beautiful place that I put
the cables.
The cable to the side. For this plane, like this, I also use a little, just this. I will put these cables here, because the place is small, but like this, I mean, look at this, do you see now? I have the cable here, which it wouldn't be possible if I didn't cut the foam off, eh?
Uh-huh.
I mean, this is unbelievable, look at this, eh? And this is unbelievable, eh? For such a small plane, and it fits the battery inside so perfect. And now listen to this, I will put it on the flat surface. Level it a little. I don't know if you have to, because I think that the first time that you bind the plane, it knows what the level surface is. Now look at this.
What do you have in the middle position throttle?
Yeah, and that's it, eh? It doesn't matter. Yeah, it doesn't matter. It has bounded. And now
what's with you and those throttle sticks all the time,
because you have to have the throttle here in the middle position if you want to put it in the box.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because it has the holes. But it doesn't matter.
If it's not throttle cut, then it's the middle position.
Now you have here, of course, the button for the acrobatics. If you press this quick and in a few beeps, you have the time to do something or up elevator or maybe aileron or something. It will remember and do the loop and the roll. And of course, here you have the three positions. The beginner with the fully gyro, the mid rates, which you have more authority, but still the gyro is working. And of course you have the zero position, the down, on which you have the total control of the plane, which I have, which in fact I have tried with the Mustang, but that was really okay. It was flying like crazy, because at that time, if you will fly in the expert mode, you will really see if you need to trim plane something.
I think
because
that
as long as you have the gyro, I the gyro is trimming
the plane.
You
know what I think?
What?
That we actually came here to fly.
Of course. And now I will assign the throttle. Look at this. Push the throttle forward and down. Uh-huh. And now I have the throttle. Look at this.
Oh.
And believe me, listen to the sound, eh?
Oh.
Yeah, but this in fact is enough thrust. It is more than one to one ratio.
Yeah.
It can climb. And of course, you can hear the gyro working. It stays like this. Do you see this, eh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It's strange. Why is this? But I can level it right now. Look at this. If I just push it a little, look, and it stays like this.
Uh-huh.
But once you will do this, do you see?
Yeah.
They stay in strange positions, but that doesn't matter, because in fact, when it will be flying, it starts to correct immediately the plane.
Yes.
So this is it. Now I just wonder how I will hand launch this. Now even with this prop, it still says 14 plus years. It's not a toy. I mean, I don't know what to call this, eh? But I don't think that this prop in the back can bite you much on the hand, but it still can, eh? So maybe I can just throw it like this, eh?
Yeah, maybe you can.
Because the gyro is working, and maybe I will just put the throttle and throw it like this, and that's it. And just one thing I will show you also, that in fact, it does have, look at this, the rubber nose, eh? So you don't break it. I mean, this is a unbelievable for such a small plane, eh? And now I just hope that we will see something today that I will be able to fly this. Because I know right now that this plane will be faster than...
Everyone loves a rubber on the nose, eh?
Yeah, of course, on the nose, yeah.
Yes,
that it will be faster than the the Mustang. Now the wind almost stopped.
Yes.
Do we have some wind anywhere? Doesn't matter. So I will take off I don't like the sun in my eyes.
You have to, yes, like this, yes.
This is unbelievable. Like this.
Uh-huh.
I will.
Should I press the button?
I must let, no, don't push something. The maiden flight with the beautiful and sexy Ishin F-16 mini devil, mini
now fly falcon, on that side.
Mini falcon or something, eh? Or should I show, I will throw it like this, huh?
I think this will
you
be
think
okay.
It will be okay?
Of course.
But even if you will...
even if you will crash, you will not...
Yeah, you won't crash even if it won't work, no? I just, I'm watching this rather a little, but hey. The vertical stabilizer.
Yes.
Let's hope that it will work, eh? I will just put the full throttle and what the hell. Let's hope that the gyros will be working. Are you ready, Captain Blush, to see something, eh?
Yes.
Again, I have the problem with my finger here on the throttle. I don't have the big stick here now. So this is it?
Yes.
Here goes nothing, they say Americans, eh?
Yes. And there, and you were right, eh?
Yeah. Here goes nothing, eh? Yeah, but this was the test, that in fact now we know...
That you have to throw it a bit harder, I think,
I must clean it because, hey, I love to have my planes beautiful and sexy.
You don't have like to walk back. You just throw it from here.
Yeah. So this does not work, even though it has much thrust, but hey, then I will just... Yeah, but we have a little wind. Maybe the wind was not helping. I will throw it in
do
this
it,
direction.
Okay,
no?
Do it like this.
Yeah, but I have the sun in my eyes.
Yeah, there's always something, eh?
I don't have the time to put my hands on the throttle back, eh?
But you have to have full throttle.
To put... Are you ready?
Yeah.
Huh? Oh yeah!
Over my head, like.
Hey, but don't moan again, Captain Blush. I'm trying to get my hand back on the sticks, eh? I'm doing my best, eh?
Is it nose light?
It's perfect. But the wind is tossing it a little, do you see?
Yes.
But it flies pretty good, eh? Do you see it?
It sounds like
I
a
mean,
bee.
It's a little more wobbly.
It sounds like
a
Mustang. It sounds like a beehive.
A little more wobbly than the Mustang, but still good, eh? Look at this, eh? The full speed, eh? Do you see it good?
Uh-huh.
Not bad, eh? Now, of course, I can see right now that this plane is...
What?
For the totally calm days.
Of course.
Because the wind is tossing it a little, it is wobbly, but it's still so much fun, eh? Look at this, eh?
Don't fly too far away because every time you go too far it blurs.
It blurs?
And then I cannot see the plane.
I will fly closer. Do you see it?
No. No. It was blurring for 30 seconds.
Yeah, well this one is small viewer say. Now this one is small, but hey.
I'll just not zoom nothing because every time I zoom I lost the plane.
I'll just fly closer. Yeah, I will do a loop, but what's the point? Because you won't see it.
No, don't do a loop because I can't even see it.
Yeah, oh, but this is amazing, eh? But you can see that if you want to fly it good, I'm flying almost all the time.
Full throttle?
Yeah. A little up. Do you see it now?
No.
Uh-huh.
I'm just following the sound.
You see it now?
Yeah, I do see it, but I cannot zoom. Uh-huh. Every time I zoom, it's out of focus. And
I just feel like this. You don't have to zoom. Let's see how much we can suck from this. Eh?
Yeah, I will not wait 15 minutes for suck this because I cannot see it.
Now the last flyby, and then I will land. Yeah, but it looks so sexy, eh? It like a real one, eh? Once more I will come by. And now I will land, are you ready?
Yes. At least I got the landing in the camera.
You got at least this, eh?
Because stand there. This will be my worst filming ever, eh?
Well, you didn't have the second hand on the camera.
Because of the sun, I had to do it like this. To get shades on my eyes.
Well, hey, let's hope that you got something, eh?
Well, I did got something, but it is so small that the camera burns all the time, eh? But it is sexy.
Now the point is, of course, that we have tested this, and I can tell you that this was one great experience, eh? This, on the flyby, say, and I will show you, in fact, look, you will see. Look.
Oh.
You see this, look.
So it's almost one-to-one, eh?
Yeah.
For such a small engine, it not suck, but this one doesn't suck, but push.
I mean, this is unbelievable. Of course, I will unplug it now.
Let me feel.
And you have seen, look, I will take the tweezers, I will take out this connector first. And you can see now, and now you can take out the battery and grab it firmly here
to the connector,
and then disconnect, and that's it, eh?
Yes.
And you are
one happy pilot.
One happy pilot all over again, eh? I must clean it good, eh? Now, good thing that I have put the lacquer on, and of course, what have we seen today? You can show it to the viewers a little more closer. Yes. Yeah. Well, this plane is small, it is the gray color, so I know that this time it was hard to film it really good. I just hope that there will be something seen on the camera.
Yeah, of course it will be, but even when I was not zooming, when you passed me, it blurred.
Yeah, I don't know why it blurred today. I mean, the days like this,
it's small.
The totally uncloudy, beautiful days are for the big planes. Because we have learned this, that if you have the fog and the heavy clouds, then the camera works the most perfect. But hey,
yes.
I hope that you have seen something, at least you have heard it. And we have learned today that in fact, I don't know, a hand launch like this is nothing, but it just needs a little push like this. And with the gyro assist, the plane will take off perfectly. Now we do have the wind, it was tossing the plane around, but hey, It's really fun, and the point is that we have tested this, and now I can tell you from the first hand that this is one great flyer. And if you're a jet lover, hey, this is one sexy plane. And don't worry because it doesn't have an EDF unit inside, because to make such a small EDF unit, that would be crazy. Even this Porsche prop, because once it's in the air, you don't see that the prop is working in the back, and still you have that wee screaming sound, eh? And the plane looks pretty sexy. But of course, I can tell you that it is not so stable as the Mustang.
No, because yeah, it's smaller wingspan. It is smaller,
even the real jet. I mean, even I have the plane like this in the 70mm wingspan, and it does need some speed to fly.
What do you say?
70mm EDF unit on. It does need some speed to fly good, and even that one was a little wobbly in the air. But still, it's great experience, and you're having fun, and that's the point of this.
Yes.
So this is it, what to tell at the end. The assessment of this, eh? Yeah. In this mini category, because this is the category of the mini planes, and since...
Under 250 grams category,
yeah,
is this.
Under 250, mini that you don't need the license for. I mean, it's amazing. You don't even have much planes in the category like this. So what to give this? I will give this plane... Yeah, what should I give it? I will give it 9.
9?
I will give it 9. I mean, it looks perfect. It is all great. I don't know. Maybe I will take that half point because I would give it 9.5. Because in such a small category, I don't think that you have much better planes than this. It's really sexy. And it flies good, but it is wobbly. But that is just, I don't know, maybe today from the wind, maybe from its size. But maybe even if the, in the cool day, the, this plane will fly like
but
this.
But who cares because if it is wobbly? It's still one piece.
The gyro must... Yeah, but the point is, yeah, you can't even crash and you have seen this.
Yeah.
You really can't crash this plane, and you don't have to worry that you will throw your money away if you would try to fly it for the first time. So maybe this is the option for you to try a little jet, eh? You don't have to spend $600 for the planes that you will crash on the maiden flight. You can buy first this one and train a little, and you will get the idea how this plane looks like when you're flying close and sexy, and how beautiful they look in the air. And then you can get to some other plane. But at the end, who cares? It's up to you to click or not, but I hope that as many viewers as possible will click someday, and you will buy yourself something, even a plane like this. So you will have the experience how it is when you are in the air with your plane, because that is, like I always say, the only time that I forget about all the troubles in the world, and that's the point, eh?
Yes.
And that you're having the fun, because you never know what will happen tomorrow. So this is it, Captain Blasinov. Pilot Robert and Captain Blas signing off from Slovenia with another test, another great maiden flight, in which even we weren't worried that we will crash something, because if you try planes like this, on these videos, you won't see crash. Word, because you can't crash the man.
Yeah.
But of course, the ultimate fun, eh? So this is it, Captain Blush.
Yes.
Thanks again for all support. Expect more, because at home is already waiting the T-28 Mini Trojan, eh?
Oh, yes.
And if I know Trojans, I know that that one will fly good, eh? And after that Trojan, it will be the iconic Whistling Dead, eh?
Yes.
So this is it. The Captain Blush cut quick! Because the friends are coming. It is Sunday afternoon. The sun is shining.
Yes.
The friends are coming, bringing their planes. And today we will have 2-3 hours here having fun and joy with the planes. We will fly a little, but even more we will talk, because that's the point, eh? It's not always just in flying, but to be with your friends, eh?
Yes.
And your family, and I don't know what. Or just come here and be with us.
And I'll just cut, because...
You cut, Kaplan, but what's with you, eh? I have to stuck in this battery, and I will suck it dry, eh, right now. Viewers, thanks again, eh?